family curse dating back to the days of slavery in America threatens the lives of great-great-grandchildren in present day. Now, that's the premise of a new novel entitled Invisible. And joining me this morning is the author, Mark Brissett. Welcome to Urban Update.
Yes, sir. How you doing?
All right. Now, let's get to the book. Good friend Jay Kosmopoulos has had this on his desk for the last month. It's 100 pages. I don't think he's gotten through it yet.
Oh, he didn't read it?
I don't know. You know,
he's
a slow reader. Okay. So, anyways, tell me a little bit about this. This is great. Even a deal that should not have been made should not be broken. What's that mean when it comes to this book in terms of Invisible, the storyline?
Well, the story starts in slavery, but the book starts with the birth of these twins. The great-great-grandmother of the twins made a deal with the devil. So that's what that's referring to. She made a deal with the devil, and then she broke it. Now, he told her, if you break this deal, pain will follow you and your family, and it won't end until one of your sons kills himself from the pain. So the book starts with the birth of the twins. Now, when you kill yourself, when you're a twin, if you kill your twin, it's in a sense killing yourself.
Okay.
So that's what that's referring to.
Okay, so this genre, you really like this. Now, you like this genre, and I heard that you also did it backwards. You made a short film first,
right.
and then the book, right?
Right, that's weird. I see in pictures.
Okay.
So I saw the movie first. That's what I saw. So I tried to do the short film, and, you know, it's good, but the sound wasn't right. The sound was a little off in places, so that's why I didn't go too far with that. But
it is weird, because usually you read the book and then you see
right.
the movie.
This right.
You see the movie and you read the book next. Now, is this something you really like, this kind of horror, suspense, thriller type? I mean, it is your first book,
yeah.
So are you going to continue in this genre, or do you see yourself down the line going in other areas?
My second one's kind of sad, too.
Yeah.
It happens that way. I didn't try to do that, just what came out.
I heard that the reason, or one of the reasons, inspirations, or at least motivations, because they were twins, was because you have twins in your family, right?
Yeah,
your mom.
Yeah, yeah.
And so that played a little bit. Tell me a little bit about that story, how that played into this.
Well, when I was little, my mother told me she was a twin. And then she told me her twin died at birth. So with my crazy warped imagination, I had this whole story conjured up where I would meet a lady in the street one day, look like my mother, try to talk to her. She didn't know who I was, because it wasn't my mother. It was a twin that wasn't really dead, and nobody knew. So that's where the idea kind of came from.
Now, what's your mom think about all this? Her being kind of the inspiration for this book about a deal with the devil and twins and
I don't know. She got it. She says, I don't know if she's reading it, but I don't know what she thinks yet.
She's going to see this interview now. We're looking at the cover now. Tell me a little bit about that cover. It's pretty interesting. I'm looking at it now on screen, Invisible. Why do you say it's invisible without giving too much of the book?
Well, it's invisible because the twins, one was raised in foster care, and one was raised with his family. And the one in foster care, all he wanted was a family. Now, when they grew up to be about 17, the twin that was in foster care found out about his twin. And he wanted that family. So he wanted to kill his twin, to live as his twin, and have the family that he wanted. And he felt he can do that because no one knew he was there. He felt invisible to his family.
So that comes up. I've been meaning to ask you that, of how it all kind of...
And that's my son.
So it is. So and what's his name?
Marcel.
You got to give him a shout out.
Marcel, what's up?
He's going to ask for some royalties now for being on the... Is he asking for a little bit of money from the sale of the book?
He gets it all, anyway.
I like it. It's called Invisible, Mark Brissett. It's about a deal with the devil that goes back to the days of slavery. Thanks a lot, brother.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very, very much. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it for this edition of Urban Update. I'd like to thank all my guests for their participation, and of course, you for watching. I'm Alberto Vesalio. Have a great Sunday, everyone.